Hello, this is Kathleen. I'm extremely humbled and extremely grateful for being pardoned and released from prison.
Calm and composed in her first public statement, Kathleen Folbigg pays tribute to the devoted few who stood by her in her darkest days.
My eternal gratitude goes to my friends and family, especially Tracy and all of her family, and I would not have survived this whole ordeal without them.
She was swiftly released into the warm embrace of her best friend yesterday.
We didn't get our steak for dinner, which was a bugger. So we've had pizza last night. We've had a bit of a flashback to 20 years. She asked for a Kahlua and Coke.
20 years between drinks, she spent her first day of freedom catching up with the world in awe of iPhones and smart TVs. It's been the simple things like patting a dog and drinking tea from a real cup that's kept her smiling.
Sounds probably pretty basic to you all, but she's grateful. Decent tea. You know, real milk, and slept in a real bed last night. So she said it was the first time she's been able to sleep properly in 20 years.
Despite the final report of the inquiry into her convictions still weeks away,
Ms. Folbigg has now been pardoned.
An unconditional reprieve with reasonable doubt raised by new scientific evidence.
The system has failed her at every step. Instead of trying to understand why her children died, we threw her in jail, locked her up, called her Australia's worst female serial killer. I mean, how would any of you feel to have that happen to you?
Today is a victory for science, and especially truth.
With comparisons drawn to the Lindy Chamberlain case, two mothers locked up, left to mourn their losses alone.
I love that little girl.
Lindy Chamberlain was released from prison after about 3 years. I don't think it's going too far to say that Kathleen Folbigg's case could be the worst miscarriage of justice in the history of Western criminal law.
Now legal experts are pushing for Australia to establish a Criminal Cases Review Commission, a statutory body working at arm's length from the courts, investigating claims of wrongful conviction, just like they have in England, Wales, Scotland, New Zealand and Canada.
We have obviously a system here that includes appeals and a pardon system to grant them mercy, but there are holes in that system. We need a well-resourced, independent, standing Criminal Cases Review Commission that can investigate cases.
Putting a safety net on the system that left this grieving mother fighting for freedom for more than two decades.
For the last 20 years I have been in prison. I have forever and will always think of my children, grieve for my children, and have missed them and loved them terribly. Thank you.
Sadly, Kathleen's case is not isolated. Roseanne Beckett spent 10 years in jail, wrongfully convicted after being framed for attempting to solicit the murder of her husband. It took a decade to overturn her conviction, with the New South Wales government eventually paying her millions of dollars in compensation. So, Roseanne, you have a better insight on this than, well, really just about anybody else. How did it feel for you when you heard that Kathleen had been released?
I was elated. I've followed Kathleen for the whole 20 years because I believed from the beginning this woman was not guilty of murdering her children, and to see her get out yesterday was just amazing. It was wonderful.
Roseanne, what range of emotions do you go through when you're released? Because I imagine that there's some sort of euphoria, but also her whole life is tinged with sadness. How do you feel?
It's the moment you've waited for in my case, 10 years, and I'm sure in Kathleen's case, 20 years. But it's a mixed emotion because it's such an injustice. And so you've been suffering it for so long, and to finally feel that you're actually being released and that someone actually believes in you and knows that you didn't commit a crime. And there's no compassion or sympathy. Once you're in those gates, that's it, you're on your own. You know, you're very vulnerable, you have no one to turn to, and it's really, really... Only the strong can last it, I tell you. She's done well, Kathleen's done well to be able to withstand the nightmare that she would be living.
Roseanne, you said that your life had changed. Life as you knew it had changed once you left prison. In what way?
Well, honestly, just about in every way. I mean, I didn't have a computer before I went into prison. There wasn't mobile phones. I was like a child. I had my elderly parents show me how to do things. Before I went to jail, I had to use my money to pay for things. But now they're telling me you just get this card and do this, and I didn't know how to do that.
We hear you talk about that, and part of it's kind of amusing to us, right? We kind of go, yeah, wow, isn't that amazing how much that's changed? That's funny, that example you gave and so on. But, like, for you, when you're actually in that situation, how, I don't know, untethered or just alienated from the whole world do you feel? Like, do you feel like you're an alien on another planet and nothing is easy? What's that psychological toll like?
You hit the nail on the head. You do feel like you're on another planet. Honestly, I really did think they had done something to me, given me an injection and taken me somewhere overseas or somewhere, because I didn't think I was in Australia. I really didn't.
Kathleen's closest supporters say that she isn't angry, she's got no bitterness. The strength that's required to stay locked up when you know you're innocent just blows my mind. How do you keep going in prison when you know you shouldn't be in there?
Like Kathleen, when I came out, I just felt a peace. I felt maybe at last this wrong is going to be rectified and now people will know. And I must go on because I now have set a precedent. So people coming behind me don't have to fight for the 30 years I had to fight for to receive justice. It was already well known I was innocent and that had been proven time and time again. But it didn't stop these wicked people through putting me through these paces time after time. But my stand was for all Australians, for especially women, because it's very hard for women. Yeah. And they do hit women harder than they do men, unfortunately, yeah. But that's the truth of it. Yeah. And it shouldn't be that way.
It's certainly been a real theme in Kathleen's story, in yours as well, Roseanne. There's no doubting that. Roseanne, I imagine it's actually not that easy for you to talk to us about this sort of stuff, but your insight is just invaluable at a moment like this. So thank you so much for being prepared to do it. We've been enriched by hearing from you.
Thank you. Thank you for hearing me, and I ask everyone to support Kathleen because she's going to need it.